Assalamu alaikum, dear Sebastians. I am Farah Riaz, your arts and design teacher. I hope that you are safe and secure with your family. Be responsible and protect your family and yourself by following all the safety precautions. Spend your available time wisely and usefully. Positive energy is all you need to spend a fulfilling day. Involve yourself and your family in positive activities, and definitely arts is one of them. As you know, that you and your family have a lot of spare time on your hands apart from the ongoing and regular studies on Chandbagh Online Learning YouTube channel. You can spend some very, very fun time with your family members if you involve them with you in arts activities. The information that I will be sharing with you, everybody in your home can benefit from it. So let's start. Languages, as you know, for instance, in English language, if you want to master yourself in this language, it is very important that you know what alphabets are, what vowels are, and what consonants are. That is going to help you form sentences, and that is how you proceed to improve your vocabulary. In the same way, likewise, in arts, there are some very important and essential elements and fundamentals which you need to know and understand to become an artist. So let's find out what these the fundamentals of art are. The fundamentals of art are what I consider to be the building blocks of an artwork. They are line, shape, form, space, texture, value, and color. These fundamentals are generally universal across different mediums and styles. Learning them will help you become a well-rounded and versatile artist. If you look up at a picture, you can break down that picture in these seven elements. Line. The path of a point moving in space. Line can vary in length, width, curvature, color, and direction. As you can see that in this block, there are all different kinds of lines. You can see zigzag lines, you can see squibbly lines, you can see crisscross lines. These lines form the edges that you draw in any picture. Shape. That is a two-dimensional area or plane that may be open or closed, freeform or geometric. It can be found in nature or is made by humans in geometry. Color. Color is one of the most dominant elements. It is created by light. There are three properties of color: hue, which is the actual name, value, which are the shades, and intensity, that is the brightness or the dullness of any color. Texture. This describes the feel of an actual surface, the surface quality of an object. Value. Value is the degrees of lightness and darkness, the graduations of light and dark on the surface of objects. Form. Objects that are three-dimensional and have length, width, and height, they can be viewed by more than one side. Forms take up space and volume. Space is used to create the illusion of depth, emptiness, or area between surrounding or contained within objects, shape, and form. Now, for the starters, what you can do to practice these seven elements is that you can look at this picture and indicate and mark all the seven elements in this painting. You will find line, shape, color, texture, value, form, space, all of these things in this one painting. In the same manner, what you can do is at home, you can grab any newspaper, any magazine, any home family photo album, and you can just work out all these seven elements that you have seen. I will be uploading another lesson, which will be the beginner's and starter's guide for sketching and shading. And after that, inshallah, you and your family members will be able to grab a pencil and pour out your emotions on a piece of paper. Till then, Allah Hafiz, and please stay safe and secure with your family.